Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the components for encryption and compression from within the SSIS Productivity Pack. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack has two task components at the control flow level: the compression task and the PGP task. These components are for the specific tasks of encryption and compression. The compression task can compress or decompress zip files within SSIS. The PGP task can be used to encrypt or decrypt files using PGP algorithms. For today's demo, we will begin with compression task first, followed by the PGP task. Let's start by dragging the compression task from the SSIS toolbox to the control flow design surface. The general page is where we specify the general settings of this component. There are two supported behaviors. We can compress a file or folder using the zip archive file format. We can also decompress a compressed file of the zip archive file format to an uncompressed file or folder. As mentioned, we can compress either a file or directory as specified in the source type field. When compressing a directory, we also have the option to include subdirectories. When we select the decompress action, the source type can only be file, as we can only decompress a file at a time. For the purpose of demonstrating the compression task, we will select the compress action and directory as the source type. The path fields for both source and destination are pretty straightforward. The source path indicates the location of a file or folder to compress or decompress. The destination path specifies where the resulting compressed or decompressed file or folder will be located. We also have the option to overwrite existing items when compressing or decompressing. In the advanced settings, we can set a password to be applied to the compressed or decompressed file that is created. I will quickly specify a password here. The compression level determines the strength of compression used. There are four options available, an ascending order of strength from none to best compression. The higher the compression level, the longer the compression will take, but the smaller the resulting compressed file will be. Lastly, the temporary directory path specifies the location of the temporary files. Temporary files are created when compressing or decompressing. You can also choose to leave this field as empty, in which case the temporary files will be created in the default temporary folder for the operating system. We can now navigate to the error handling tab, where we can specify if the task should continue or stop when an error is encountered. Click OK to finish configuring this task component. We can now execute this task. We will now demonstrate the PGP task. As mentioned before, the PGP task is an SSIS control flow task that can be used to perform encryption, decryption, or file signature actions. Let's drag the PGP task from the SSIS toolbox to the control flow design surface. Double-click it to open its editor form. There are four actions to choose from: encrypt, decrypt, create signature, and verify signature. The encrypt option encrypts a file using a public key. It can be decrypted using a corresponding private key. The decrypt option decrypts an encrypted file using a private key, as seen in the bottom of the editor form. The Create Signature option creates a signature file from a source file. The Verify Signature option verifies that the source file has not changed using a signature file and a public key. For today's example, we will choose the Encrypt option. The source file path is the file that you want to take action on. For actions Encrypt, Create Signature, and Verify Signature, it will be any type of file. For the decrypt action, this will need to be an encrypted file. The signature file path specifies the location of a file signature that will be used to verify the source file. This property is only used for the VerifySignature action. Destination path is the path for any output file that will be created. The type will depend on the action being taken. For the encrypt action, this will be an encrypted file. For the decrypt action, this will be the path to the unencrypted file. For the CreateSignature method, this will be a signature file. There is an option to overwrite existing items. The last section concerns public and private keys. For today's demo, since we are choosing the encrypt action, only public key fields are available to us. As mentioned before, when working with the decrypt action, the private key fields will be enabled. The public key location specifies the location of the public key that will be used. A public key file can contain multiple keys if it is a key ring. The public key ID field allows you to select the specific key to use. The private key location specifies the location of the private key that will be used. The private key password is used in conjunction with the private key as an extra layer of security. If you do not have an existing public-private key pair, you can generate a new one using the Generate New Key Pair button. Launching the dialog window will let you specify the public key identifier, public key path, and private key pass phrase. Keys will be immediately generated at the specified paths. Lastly, we have an expression editor if you would like to set the paths for some of the above properties from a variable. Here you can select a property and set its expression to a variable or any other type of expression. We can now navigate to the error handling tab, where we can specify if the task should continue or stop when an error is encountered. The next section is only enabled when the Verify Signature action is selected from the general page before. This provides options for what to do with signature verification results. You can raise an error on a failed signature verification. If the output result to variable option is selected, a combo box will allow the selection of a Boolean data type variable. Click OK to configure this task component. We can now execute this task. This concludes a demonstration of the encryption and compression task within our SSIS Productivity Pack. There are many other components in the SSIS Productivity Pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.